obesity, heart disease, so heart attack, strokes, type 2 diabetes, dementia, so Alzheimer's, various inflammatory conditions like arthritis and gout. What do these things have in common? It's not obesity, it's not laziness. There's one thing that they have in common, and that is insulin. Too much insulin. We produce too much insulin, we become insulin resistant, and when we are insulin resistant, our production goes way high and we develop hyperinsulinemia, which is very, very inflammatory and leads to all those diseases and all those conditions, most of which are treatable to a point with medications that control the symptoms but do nothing to cure them or reverse them. The only way you can cure or reverse or prevent any of those conditions is by not having elevated insulin levels. So we have to control our insulin production. Welcome to Shape Fixer. I'm Andrew. I'm the nutritionist. I was obese. I had heart problems. I had arthritis. I have reversed all those things. I had gout as well, which also disappeared. And my insulin is under control. And it's a simple answer, but not an easy thing to do. And in this video, I'm going to explain to you why that is. So, insulin. Insulin rises, it's produced in our pancreas, and it rises in our blood according to how much sugar we eat, right? So the moment your blood sugar, which is glucose, goes up, your insulin level goes up because insulin is needed to transport that sugar around and deliver it around the body for burning. So that all sounds like it makes perfect sense. The problem is we eat way too much sugar. Now don't go away, just hang a second. If you think you don't eat sugar because you don't sprinkle white grains of sugar on your food and because you're not eating candies and sweets and cakes, well done, but you're not there yet. Most sugar is hidden. We don't recognize it. We don't even taste it because it's not even sweet. The only kind of sugar that is sweet is fructose. Fructose is found in table sugar. It makes up half of your table sugar, and it's the fructose that you taste. Fructose is also in fruit. It's called fruit sugar sometimes. It makes fruit taste sweet, but not all fruit is as sweet. A banana, for example, is nowhere near as sweet as a grape or a peach. That's because it has less fructose, but it has lots and lots of glucose, which is the other sugar which doesn't taste as sweet. And when we eat a lot of sugar, our insulin levels go up. And most of the sugar we eat is in starch, which is plant sugar. Plants produce sugar in the form of glucose, which they store as starch, which we then eat when we eat the grains. So the rice, the corn, the oats, the wheat, anything produced with wheat. We're also, when we eat potatoes, we're eating starch. We are eating the plant's spare store of sugar. So we're eating lots more sugar than we realize. So our insulin levels go up, and as they go up more and more often and higher and higher and higher, we become resistant to the insulin, and our bodies require more to really believe, if you like, that, oh, okay, this really is an insulin increase, we need to absorb some sugar, and we need to do something with it. And we end up with so much glucose in our system and so much insulin in our system that it literally poisons us. High insulin, chronic continuous high insulin, is known as hyperinsulinemia, and it is very, very inflammatory. It damages your arteries, it leads to diabetes, it leads to fatty liver disease, it leads to heart disease. It creates inflammation, so you end up with arthritis and gout issues. And of course, there are other cofactors like cigarette smoking or damage to your cartilage. You know, when you're talking about arthritis, for example, there are lots of other inflammatory behaviors, but insulin is the key. If we can control our insulin, get the insulin levels down, we will lower our risk of developing a lot of those conditions like Alzheimer's, which actually is now known in research circles as type 3 diabetes. It is an insulin disease. Heart disease, cancers, obesity, and obviously diabetes, and you don't want diabetes. You're going to lose your toes, you're going to lose your feet, you're going to go blind. Diabetes is a horrific disease. Taking drugs or medications to control those diseases, to control the symptoms, does nothing to cure you or reverse it. You can only cure yourself of those diseases, or at least reverse them, by lowering your insulin. And the only way you're going to lower your insulin is to stop eating sugar. Now, I've got good news. You don't need sugar. You really don't. We have thought for a long time that the macronutrients, the main nutrient types, are protein, fat, and carbohydrates, which is a euphemism. It's another word for sugar. Proteins, fats, and sugars. Yes, you need proteins to build your body and to make hormones. You need fats to build your cell membranes and to build your brain, which is 30% fat, and your nervous system. Sugar, what for? Nothing. There's no nutrient in sugar whatsoever. Have you ever heard of an essential sugar? No. Essential amino acids in proteins? Yes. Essential fats? Yes. Minerals, vitamins? Yes. Essential sugar? No such thing. So you don't really need sugar, but you need energy. The good news is you can burn fat. But you can't burn fat if you are eating sugar, because your body will take the sugar instead. And with that rise in insulin that will happen immediately that you eat sugar, that insulin stimulates fat storage. It closes off fat burning. So you are going to get fatter and fatter and fatter the more sugar you eat, because you can't burn the fat. So you need to stop eating the sugar. You need to cut carbohydrates down as much as possible, avoid the sugars, increase your fat, because we now understand fat doesn't make you fat, sugar makes you fat. And you will not have nearly the same risk of heart disease and diabetes and Alzheimer's and cancers and various inflammatory diseases. It's quite simple. It's the insulin, baby. It's not because you're lazy. It's not because you're not getting exercise. Exercise is good for you, obviously. But when you are insulin resistant and you are obese, and your hormones are being ruined by the insulin, so you don't even know when you're properly hungry or not. The insulin makes you think you're hungry all the time, so you overeat and you keep doing it. You can't undo the process. You need to stop eating carbohydrates. And that is as simple as it gets. Now, I've done videos on various conditions and diseases, and I've done videos on sugar that explain in more detail what types of sugar there are and how to identify them. And I've done video on nutrition and how to eat to a healthy diet and avoiding sugar. And I'm going to put all those videos in the notes down below here. I'll stick some of them up here somewhere on the screen so that you can go and have a look at. But subscribe to the channel, click the bell so that you know when I've done another video, because I'm going to do a video on diabetes. On type 2 diabetes, because it is such a problem. It's such a common problem, and millions of people suffer from type 2 diabetes, and the treatment is wrong. The treatment is a treatment. It's not a cure. It's not a cure. People aren't being cured of their type 2 diabetes. It's being managed, and they live with it for the rest of their lives, and it slowly gets worse. So their medication dose increases with time, and they get fatter, they get less able to do anything, they develop secondary diseases and conditions, and eventually you have your toes amputated, or your feet amputated, or your leg amputated, or you lose your eyesight. And this is while you're on medication for 20-30 years. You can reverse type 2 diabetes in 1 to 3 months. 100%, completely cure, reverse it, without buying any medication or paying any fee or buying a gadget or glucose monitors and all those wonderful things. You don't need any of that stuff. You can reverse it yourself, because thousands and thousands of people have done it. It's simple. It is a dietary disease, so you can fix it with diet. You can't fix dietary disease with medication, because that implies that you're not changing the diet that caused the disease in the first place. So how is it ever going to go away? It isn't. The problem, the biggest problem we face, is hyperinsulinemia, which comes about as a result of insulin resistance, and we are becoming resistant to insulin because we produce too much of it and our bodies get sick to death of it because we eat too much sugar. That's how simple it is. Thank you for your time. Thank you for subscribing. Remember to click the bell and watch some of these other videos that explain more detail about a lot of these issues. I'm also going to do a video very shortly on Alzheimer's dementia and what the research says and why researchers are calling it type 3 diabetes. That is really, really interesting. Thank you again for your time.